Fingerprint recognition is probably something you think only exists in detective films. But have you ever thought about the security measures put in place to protect the most important things in the world? We're not just talking money here either, but DNA, art collections, or seeds. Whereas most of us might just padlock our expensive items, when it's the government trying to keep things secret, it's a whole other story. From armed guards, it's surprising how inventive some of these places have become to keep their secrets, quite literally, under lock. It may be difficult to access a lot of these buildings, but it's easy to access our videos. So before we start, make sure you click on the subscribe button to make sure you can view our other videos too. Svalbard Global Seed Vault. Halfway between Norway and the North Pole lies the Svalbard Global Seed Vault, the largest and most secure collection of crop diversity in the world. It's tucked deep inside a mountain on a tiny island in the Svalbard archipelago and has been built to withstand almost every type of disaster, ranging from natural to man-made. There are more than 1,700 gene banks all over the world, but the Svalbard Global Seed Vault is the most secure. It was created to hold backups of thousands of different plants, which can be replanted in the future, if things like population growth or climate change affect the world's plant selection. Svalbard Global Seed Vault is located in the most northern location that a person can fly to on a standard flight. However, due to its almost freezing climate, it's not your typical tourist destination. This weather helps to secure the seeds, and its mountainous structure protects it from flooding, too. All the countries that have contributed to the stock control their own access to the seeds. There are strict national and international laws that must be followed when it comes to depositing, and a complex black box system means only a select few can even enter the area. Vatican Secret Archives. The Vatican Secret Archives have always been shrouded in mystery, but a lot of this originates from a simple mistranslation. The full name of the archives is Archivum Secretum Apostolicum Vaticanum. People seem to assume that the secretum means secrets, but it doesn't. In actuality, it translates to private or personal, and the contents reflect this. The archives have been around for over 200 years, but they're almost as difficult to access now as they were back then. A few groups of people are not allowed to enter at all, like students, journalists, or amateur historians. In order to be allowed entry, you have to prove you're a serious scholar. And even then, you're only granted access for 6 months before you have to apply again. So it's slightly more difficult to get into the Vatican archives than it is for your standard university library. Seeing as how you can't even get through the doors without walking past guards, it's probably not somewhere you'd visit in a rush either. There are 50 miles worth of shelved documents inside the archives, and anyone who enters is only allowed to read 3 per day. To make matters even more difficult, the scripts are handwritten in Latin or Italian. Inside are wonders such as Michelangelo's letter to Pope Julius II and scripts dating back to the 8th century. Cheyenne Mountain Complex. It shut down over 10 years ago when the threat from Russia was thought to subside, but recently, the Cheyenne Mountain Complex has been announced as home for some of the US military's equipment again. Based in Colorado, the bunker is built under 2,000 feet of the Rocky Mountains. It's never happened, but it's thought to be able to withstand a 30 megaton nuclear blast. It's also surrounded by 25-ton blast doors. Fingers crossed we don't have to test that one out, though. The North American Aerospace Command used the complex to prepare for World War III, if it ever happened. It spans across a half acre and had poised airmen dotted around who would send signals in case of attack. At its peak, there were 1,100 people working inside the mountain. Those rare few who are allowed to visit must sign a document and are warned that employees may use deadly force to protect the site if necessary. 4 armed guards also follow a visitor at all times. Aside from looking out for danger 24/7, the mountain is also home to 6 million gallons of stored water. Those who work in the bunker eat calorie-dense ready meals and sleep in shared cots. The mountain is pretty much a tiny habitat, which seems to be the cost to keep America safe. Area 51. It's one of America's worst-kept secrets, and as a result, Area 51 is surrounded by mystery. Roughly 100 miles north of Vegas, it's commonly thought that the government uses the area to conduct research on alien aircraft and clone extraterrestrials. Obviously, none of this has ever been confirmed. Even though it's a real place, satellite images of Area 51 were deleted from the public database for years. Even when Skylab astronauts accidentally photographed the area in 1973, the CIA censored the image to stop it from being released publicly. To access the site is virtually impossible. Not only is it very remote, but it's also close to the Nevada National Security Site where the government tests nuclear weapons. So it's not somewhere you'd want to stumble across by accident. If you want to go there, you need a personal invitation from the highest level of intelligence services as well as a full security clearance. The area is surrounded by, well, nothing for thousands of acres, and it's common for maps to leave out the roads that lead to Area 51. Those who work at the site must sign an oath swearing secrecy, and a complete lack of windows means no bystanders could even sneak a peek while hiking. Bank of England Gold Vault. We all knew London was an expensive place to visit anyway, but did you know the Bank of England Gold Vault is home to approximately one-fifth of the world's gold? It's worth an estimated $248 billion, which is probably why it's so difficult to gain access. Based under the Bank of England in the center of London's financial district, the gold weighs nearly 7,000 tons and takes up 300,000 square feet of space. The vaults are so huge because gold can only be stored so high because of its weight. Stacking too many gold bars on top of each other will result in the ground sinking, because their clay exteriors weigh less than the gold. The vaults were built in the 1930s and require several 3-foot-long keys to gain access. These keys are thought to be more secure than the accompanying electronic security system, which consists of voice recognition from a short pre-recorded list of people. The space was originally used during the war, so it's likely that it's entirely bomb-proof too. If you want to take a look inside the vaults for free, you can do a virtual tour on the website. It's likely that this will be the closest you'll ever get to the gold, unless you're Queen Elizabeth II, who got her own private guided tour in 2012. Fort Knox. You might not recognize it by its official name, the United States Bullion Depository, but Fort Knox was home to the US Army for 60 years. It covers ground of over 109,000 acres in Kentucky and is surrounded by granite walls and a bomb-proof wall. It also has fences, multiple alarms, and Apache helicopter gunships guarding its contents. The Federal Reserve estimates a value of over $168 billion for all the gold that's hidden away inside Fort Knox. Gold isn't typically considered to be a significant part of the US economy anymore, but the amount of security protecting the complex would suggest it's more important than everyone is letting on. The building was first constructed in 1861, but it wasn't used as a permanent camp for another 70 years. This second camp, named after the Continental Army's Chief of Artillery, Henry Knox, was finished in 1936, and at the start of 1937, the gold was carried in by train. During this time, a US cavalry brigade protected Fort Knox. Other than gold, the area has also stored the Declaration of Independence, the US Constitution, and the Magna Carta in the past. There are currently nearly 4,300 soldiers and civilians employed at the post, and it's only one of three army camps across the USA that still has a high school located there. Korean Demilitarized Zone. North Korea is known for being a dangerous place anyway. But the Korean Demilitarized Zone, which falls between the north and south of the country, is one of the most heavily guarded places in the world. The zone is 160 miles long and around 2.5 miles wide. The area can only be accessed with special permission, although there is a set meeting point at the western end of the zone where international negotiations can take place. It was originally created during the Korean War and was a crucial part of the Armistice Agreement, which asked both sides of the war to move backwards 2,200 yards, creating the zone. Despite the war ending years ago, continual hostility between both sides of the country has meant the area is still heavily guarded on both sides. Soldiers may cross through the area, but must avoid a special part of it, the military demarcation line. This area, in particular, is regularly patrolled, and more than 800 soldiers from both parts of Korea and the USA have lost their lives whilst inside the Korean Demilitarized Zone. However, there are some supposedly secret tunnels that could be used to cross the zone. South Korea has discovered four of these tunnels since 1974, which were thought to be used as military invasion routes for North Korean soldiers. Federal Reserve Bank of New York. It guards over $200 billion worth of gold, which makes the Federal Reserve Bank in New York the world's biggest vault. As a result, it's pretty well guarded. Nobody has ever tried to rob the bank, but with only one way in or out, we're not surprised. Although it's based in New York, the majority of the gold stored here doesn't actually belong to the USA. Instead, countries from all around the world store their gold at the vault because of its security measures and safe location. A massive advantage to this is the accounts are not identifiable by country or individual owner, but simply by an account number. It's a pretty good deal for this type of security. The bank stores all the gold for free, except for a $1.75 movement fee per gold bar. And if you're moving gold around, we're pretty sure paying a couple of dollars won't dent your savings too badly. Armed guards surround the entire building with automatic weapons in hand. Before you enter the vault, you must leave all of your belongings outside. Then, after a very thorough security check, you can go inside the actual gold chamber. We guess you can't be too careful when it comes to looking after a quarter of the world's gold reserves. Tumen River. Also in North Korea, the Tumen River is thought to be the easiest way to cross over into China, but it's not without huge risks. The river is short and narrow and can be crossed on foot for the most part. Apparently, large stretches of the river are unguarded, but many North Koreans wait weeks or months for the perfect occasion to cross without getting caught. This is a wise idea. During the winter, the river freezes over and many who risk the journey at this time of year do not survive the cold temperatures. Those wishing to tackle the river can cross into China or Russia, but the Russian side is thought to be far harder to get into due to rigorous security patrols. Soldiers who guard the area have been known to let refugees through if they can provide money or bribes, but if smugglers can't pay up, the soldiers spare no sympathy. In 2003, due to a large influx of North Koreans crossing the border illegally, the Chinese government transferred responsibility for border control from the police to the army. More recently, they have also focused on building new fences around the border and stepping up the patrols. New patrol posts have been built on higher ground to ensure improved visibility, and barbed wire will soon sit at the top of the fence to well and truly put anyone off from crossing the river. Iron Mountain. Located 220 feet underground and spanning 1.7 million square feet lies Iron Mountain. It's home to Edison's patent for the light bulb, an original photo of Einstein, and more. In addition, it's thought to look after an awful lot of the US government's documents. With two waves of armed guards on the outside, you can expect a pretty thorough search before being allowed entry inside. It's housed in a former limestone mine, which means it should be protected from all forms of disaster. Based in Boston, Massachusetts, it collects deliveries of documents almost every day of the week, which can then be stored at the facility for decades. Apparently, the insides of Iron Mountain look pretty normal, but it contains 225 individual vaults on a complex 7-layer system. Each has its own combination to ensure no one else can access its contents. Even a lot of the staff don't know the intricacies of what lies within each box. And after having to go through vigorous security and background checks before gaining employment, we're not surprised they keep their heads down. All we know is that along with important documentation like birth and death certificates, almost anything can be held at Iron Mountain. Think of art collections, instruments, or even DNA. If this video hasn't got you second-guessing everything you know about the government and other secret institutions, then we're not sure what will. Luckily, you don't need any selection of keys or secret passcodes to watch The Hub, so make sure you've taken advantage of this and click subscribe to watch our other interesting videos. Thanks!